Hi everyone, welcome to the 11th edition of my plectrum guitar lesson series. Today we are going to see 5 guitar strumming patterns that will make you a very good rhythm guitarist. So without further ado, let's dive into the first strumming pattern. Down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. So it is down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. So we have a chord progression for this. Make sure you count and play the downstroke and upstrokes by looking at this diagram, and you can easily play this strumming pattern. So when you look at this diagram, the numbers represent on which fret you have to put the bar, following that which chord shape you have to apply, and the final chord names that are highlighted in the red color are the resulting chord names. Play the next chord progression with the same strumming pattern that we have seen. The next strumming pattern is down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. For the next chord progression, we are having a slight variation. Play the strumming pattern once for E minor completely. Then for G major, play only the first 6 counts. And play the next 10 counts for D major. I'll play this a little faster. The third strumming pattern is a very basic pattern, but we are going to apply a small change while playing the strumming. That is called swinging rhythm. So when you normally play this strumming pattern, it will sound like this. When you play in a swing rhythm, it will sound like this. Okay, now let's play along with the muting. Okay, now let's play the entire chord progression. Thank you. you see this strumming pattern, I will start moving to the next chord during the count 7. And I will play the upstroke as well for the next chord. So, if you have noticed, I transition to the next chord during the count 7 and played the 8th count, that is your upstroke, as well in the next chord. Okay, and then I play the strumming pattern continuously on the next chord. So during this down 7th count, I move to the next chord A, and then I play the upstroke as well, that is your 8th count in A, and then I continue to play the strumming pattern. Now let's play this pattern little faster. The next pattern is down, 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 up. So it is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's move to the next strumming pattern. To understand this, just listen to this strumming pattern. So this strumming pattern is like downstroke, following upstroke and downstroke on muted, and then upstroke, following downstroke and upstroke on muted, then downstroke for 2 counts, and then you pass for 4 counts, and then you play down, 2, down, up, next chord. Okay, when you see this diagram, there is a 4 count pass, you don't play anything there. So it is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Play the next chord progression for the same strumming pattern. Let's play this chord progression little faster. So that's it for today. We will meet in the next video and we will learn how to play the major scales and minor scales in a very easier way. I have devised my own way of playing these major scales and minor scales called two finger pattern. I will explain this in our next video. Until then, bye bye.